comes the modifies. Off turn number four, green flag. Side three. Bucko Brand in the number 20, trying to make the pass to the lead off turn number four. Even down the front stretch. Brand's running at the line. Patrick Dupree, now Mark Panadola taking the second one. He's trying to move up to third. Kenny Davies has that position. Find a way around. He's got a run up to the wall. Look out, here's a throw on the inside. Mark Panadola will take the lead away. Screwing in at 69. And up to the round of the top two. Four wide down the front stretch.
A very pleasant good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Motorsports Magazine from the Airborne Speedway in Plattsburgh. I'm Rick Knowles, joined on the broadcast by Rob Knowles. Our videographers are from OutsideGroove.com, Gene Gagne and Bobby Castine. Rob, a good field of cars over in the garage area tonight. Some of the questions we're going to have answered. First of all, can Mike Bruno make it three in a row in the dirt car modifieds?
That'll be awfully tough for Mike Bruno. I figure with handicap, he'll be starting deeper in the pack. We've got some other drivers that are looking to get to victory lane for the first time. A driver like George Foley. Patrick Dupree as well figures to be starting ahead of Bruno. Bruno had a mishap in one of the qualifying practices as well, running on the outside. He got run into by one of the other modified drivers, so we'll see if perhaps that has a negative toll on his chances tonight.
In the sportsman division, we saw Larry Underwood get career win number one last week. We've got another driver returning tonight. Big orange in the Watson glass, number 09, Richie Watson is here tonight. So a good field of sportsmen.
Well, in a sportsman class, starting down on the inside, and the inside line seems to help out. Starting up front seemed to help out. Last week, Larry Underwood started on the pole. He was able to keep his car down on the inside. Nobody could get past, and he raced home to his first checkered flag of his career.
Certainly, Rob, a couple of divisions that have had no shortage of car counts are the four-cylinder classes, and we've got a great field again tonight.
Those cars just keep growing. Their divisions are putting on some exciting races, and the numbers in both the Warriors and the Bombers continue to increase. And you didn't mention the Renegades, Rick. In the Renegade class, we've seen some of the best racing here at the Speedway all year. So it should be another good Saturday night of local short track racing.
In our interview segment, Rob will be talking with father and son modified team, Mike and Craig Riel, as well as last week's Renegade winner, Little Joe Daniels, and former track champion Toby Ebersol in the sportsman division. We want to thank Calvin Castine from Hometown Cable for his assistance in getting Motorsports Magazine on the air, and we invite you to join the Hometown Cable family. You can see the address at the close of tonight's program. So without further ado, let's go to the videotape and head over to the garage area. We'll have some interviews.
Joining me now on Motorsports Magazine, he's from Peru, New York. He's a driver in the J&S Steel Sportsman Division. He drives number 82. This is Toby Ebersol. Toby, you've been at this for some time now. A lot of laps you've turned on this Airborne half mile. Take us back through the years and reminisce for us about some of your experiences and the different divisions that you've run in here at Airborne.
It was probably like 1990. We ran it with a Tiger B feature series back then. My father-in-law got me involved in it. It raced out for like 6 years. Then he passed away, so I got out of it for like 6 years, and now we're back. It's probably been 5 years in the regular Tiger division here.
And you've had some pretty good success. You've won a track championship here a couple of years. Reflect on what's been some of your most gratifying moments, some of the things that stick out in your mind as being great memories for you.
The 2005 track champion, because I raced here for so long, and it's hard. All the competition is so tough. The 2005 track champion meant a lot. I come back in 2006 and actually won it then, but the 2005 one meant the most.
Yeah, that was your first track championship in the sportsman car, and you mentioned the competition. It's very tight in the sportsman division, really set up. If you can get your car to work on the outside, you're one of a few. Talk about what you have to do to try to get your car to work on the outside in the sportsman class.
It's tough. The tires that we run, if you get up on the outside, usually you get shuffled back because the tires, the compound that they use, you're only good for 4 or 5 laps, and you just start slipping and sliding, and you fall backwards.
What could be done, Toby, to make the cars work a little bit better on the outside? You talk about the tires. Is that perhaps a key?
I would believe if with a little wider rim and a little wider tire, maybe a little different compound, then we could have a lot more side-by-side racing.
In 2008, we've seen Larry Underwood pick up his first win. Buck O'Branham has been very tough in the number 20. Assess the field for us. You're right there in the mix as well in the top five in points. But you really have to be on your game to do well in this division.
Yeah, the cars are so close. Like Buckle, you know, Robin. Chris Reeves has come a long ways this year. We got Turner. All the cars are almost impossible to pass unless they mess up.
In this division, you race with some guys that are pretty good friends. You've been working with Skip Liberty and some other drivers through the years. Talk about that type of atmosphere to work with friends, to work on these cars, and what it's all about for you.
It's fun. That's the main reason we do it. If we weren't having fun, we wouldn't do it. But we have good times over at the garage. It's all full of race car people, you know. It's fun.
Well, fun and exciting, of course, on a Saturday night, and we wish you the best of luck in 2008. We're 4 weeks into the season now, and again, you're right there again near the top of points. You've been a consistent driver in this division. What's the key to that consistency?
Some nights you just have to take what you can get, not overdrive your car. If you're third, sometimes you got to saddle for third and not take somebody out for the lead, or just be consistent, not overdrive.
And another thing that I think fans would probably notice in this division, a lot of times your car leaves in one piece. It doesn't have a whole bunch of dings and dents in it. Some weeks maybe it does, but for the most part, you seem to avoid some of the mishaps. Talk about how that happens.
Well, that's what we consider a good night, when you can come off the track and drive them on the trailer. So we take our time, be patient.
Well, again, best of luck in 2008, and thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
That's Toby Ebersole, everybody. He drives the 82 in the JNS Steel Sportsman class. Stay tuned. More Motorsports Magazine coming up. Welcome back to Motorsports Magazine. Joining me now, he drives in the Renegade division. He was last week's winner in the Renegade division as well. It's Little Joe Daniels. And the first thing is, where's the Little Joe come from?
Well, my grandfather's name is Joe, so everybody figured it'd be fitting if I was the junior. So
I like it because it makes for a neat nickname, so I like it.
Yeah, it works out nice.
All right, it just flows off the tongue, too. Well, last week you picked up your first win in one of these Renegade divisions. Talk about that win last week. It must have been pretty gratifying, just your second year in the division.
Yeah, it was great. You know, my grandfather puts a lot of time and effort into this car, and if it wasn't for him, I'd never be able to do it. And we finally got the car tuned in and hooked up, and it's a good feeling.
We were talking earlier, 2 years in racing for you. How'd you get the bug? What got you into this?
Well, I went overseas. I spent 18 months over there, and when I come back, we came to a few races, and my grandfather's been retired for quite a while, and so I kind of put the bug in his ear that I wanted to run, and so we hooked up some decent sponsors and put something together, and we had a pretty good year, but nothing like this year's turning out to be.
Well, last year, certainly a learning experience if it was your first year in a race car, and as I think back, your experiences last year, competitive, some weeks where maybe you struggled, but you seemed to get a hang of it pretty quickly. What was the key to that?
A lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of money, a lot of help from our sponsors, and a lot of help from a lot of people that know different things and different tricks, and just trying all different things and see what works.
Joe, talk about what happens for you away from the racetrack. What do you do for a living? Talk about the family situation that you might have. What else makes Joe Daniels tick aside from his habit here on Saturday nights at Airborne?
Well, I just became a correction officer 6 months ago, so I'm working down at Greenhaven. So I do all my swapping. I work doubles all week so I can get home and be home for the races on Saturday night.
Well, you've had pretty good success here in 2008. You picked up your first win. Talk about this division. The Renegade division puts on a heck of a show. There's great competition. The cars are very equal. And on any given night, there might be 15 guys who could win.
Yeah, you know what? There's at least 15 guys that can win. And, I mean, in my opinion, that this is the tightest, most competitive class here. Everybody, for the majority, races everybody pretty clean. And it makes for really good racing.
You bring up another good point. Rarely do you see a major pileup. Now, I probably jinx things with that, but rarely do you see a major pileup in this division.
Yeah, I mean, everybody uses their head. There's a lot of give and take in this class because everybody knows it's not cheap, and there's a lot of give and take, a lot of real good drivers, and like you said, there's anybody can win any given night.
Well, 4 weeks into the season, you're in the top 10 in the points. Talk about where you'd like to be maybe at the end of the season.
Well, I'd like to be in the top five, at least the top five. We worked really hard last year. We thought we had a good run, and then we ran into some trouble the last few races, and that pushed us back. I think we ended up 11th or 12th. But last year the goal was the top 10, and this year we'll just shoot for the top 5.
But most importantly, you're having fun.
Yeah, we're having a ball. We love it.
And it's a family gathering as well. It's a family event, you racing.
Yep. My grandfather's the crew chief. My Uncle Terry owns Westside Auto. He's my big sponsor. He puts a lot of time and a lot of money into it, and all my uncles are here every week, and we have a good time. It's a really good time.
Well, we wish you the best of luck and continued success.
Thank you very much.
That's Joe Daniels, everybody. He drives the 46 in the Versatile Trailer Sales Renegade division. Stay tuned. More Motorsports Magazine is coming right up. Welcome back to Motorsports Magazine. Joining me now, two drivers from the Ernie's Discount Tools Modified division. This is Dad Mike Riel, and this is son Craig Riel from West Chazee. First, let's start with Mike. You've been at this a long time. Talk about your racing experiences in the Modified, where you've run in the past, and just go back through all those years of racing that you've had.
Okay, we've been doing this, like I said, a long time. It's about 23 years I've been doing it. We started here at Airborne, back when it was dirt days. We ran about 3 years of four-cylinder. Then the last year it was dirt, we ran Modified. That was a whole different experience than what we were used to, because you actually had to kind of know exactly what you were doing. You know, back then we were just kind of winging it, and we progressed. We made Frogtown Speedway our home track for about 18 years till we came back home. We call Airborne home because, let's face it, it's 10 minutes from home. But we've had a lot of fun in the years. Again, I couldn't do it without my sponsors. I've had sponsors that have been with me for the full 23 years. That's Macy's Auto, Plattsburgh Radiator, Customs and Classics. Since we came back here to Airborne, Sheehan Pitts came on board. Atkinson's Leasing and Management came on board this year, as well as Bushy's Furniture. So, you know, we can't do it without them. If you guys out there can support those people, I would appreciate it, because, hey, let's face it, they helped me. I would do everything I can do to help them.
And Craig, you've been at this following Dad 23 years, not that long. Talk about your racing experiences and how long you've been racing.
This is going to be my 9th season racing. I started when I was 14 in four cylinders at Frogtown. I ran that for 3 years. 1 year I went into semi-pros, raced a Camaro, and then he got me into Modified, and this is going to be my 5th season now. I have a couple of his sponsors, Plattsburgh Radiator, Customs and Classics, and Atkinson Sheet Metal.
They're all helping you out. Mike, talk about it. It's got to be a little weird racing against your son. Talk about the whole family atmosphere and how important racing has been to you and to your family.
Well, you know, we have our days. You know, sometimes we disagree, sometimes we don't. As far as on the track, he's another car. You know, I know in his eyes it's a little different, you know, but in my eyes, yeah, I cut him a few more brakes than I would anybody else, but bottom line is, if we wreck the cars, we can't race. So we got to each, you know, we switched to Bicknell cars 2 years ago. Best move we ever did. The cars work so well. Craig's car is going awesome this year. We bought a new car, we got a new motor, and we're working on it. But we got his where we want it, and, you know, I don't want to take anything from him.
Hey, Craig, talk about, again, Dad touched on how the family's been involved with racing now for a lot of years. Talk about as a kid growing up, following him around the racetracks, and how important it is for the family to be involved in this.
Our whole family's involved in it. We now have our year-and-a-half-old nephew, and we all got to take part of it. It gets rough sometimes because we get into arguing, but everyone's got to support it. If they don't, it's havoc and too much confusion.
And how about at home? He finished 5th last week, was able to beat Dad. Is there a little one-upsmanship? Have you reminded Dad about that last week, and your finish better than his more than once this week?
I try to stay away from it because it only happens once in a while.
Mike, you never do anything like that, do you? You don't rub it in?
No, absolutely, I do not. Actually, I give him the credit because, let's face it, if he had a little more, he has a real, I'm not complaining, he has a really small motor. You know, his motor is down about 125 horse to everybody else's. He's just a good little driver. He drives the line. He's really hard to pass. He uses every little bit of motor we've got, goes to that track, and he gets the most out of what he got.
The competition in the Modified division at Airborne has really picked up in the last 3 or 4 years, and you've really got to have your stuff together to compete with some of these guys. talk about the field that you're up against on every Saturday night.
It's tough. They're so fast. And when we came here, we were turning over 17-second laps. And now there's guys getting into 16-1, 16-2s. You got to be on your game. Keep your focus. Keep your rhythm. Just, it's crazy. 120 miles an hour, 3 inches away from somebody, hair pulling sometimes.
Yeah, I can imagine. Pretty exciting. Mike, the direction of the track, things seem to be really going in a nice direction for the Speedway. How would you assess that?
I think they've done a wonderful job. I like to say, I've been to a lot of tracks in the Northeast. You know, we used to think Granby was a really nice track when we ran there. This is a premier track of the Northeast that I have been to. I mean, the facility is neat and clean, and they keep the show going. Different things for the kids. And let's face it, if you don't take care of the kids, you have no future. There are future racers, you know. Anytime we could sit a kid in my car or Craig's car, I'd be more than glad to do it. Because if we can get one kid in the future, that's what racing is all about. You need to keep building, you know. The cost today, it's nice to be able to have a facility like this 10 minutes from home.
Well, let me finish things up by asking you about the goals. We're now 4 weeks into the season. Where would you like to see yourself at the end of the year? We'll start with you, Mike.
God, we'd love to... I'd love to pinch one off here and win one, but, you know, if I can finish in the top 10 in points at this facility, I'd be very happy.
And Craig, how about you? Goals for 2008?
Same. I'd like to get in the top 10 in points. It's hard with the competition and everything, but if I stay on my game, it's possible.
Well, we wish you guys the best of luck. Always fun watching a father and son compete against one another, and they do a nice job in the Ernie's Discount Tools Modified Division. Thanks to Mike Riel and Craig Riel, more Motorsports Magazine from Airborne coming up.